pick up in that familiar part of the story, starting in Mark 11, verse 7. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others spread branches they had cut in the fields. Those who went ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest." Jesus entered Jerusalem and went to the temple. He looked around at everything, but since it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is a familiar part of the story for us, of Jesus' entry into Jerusalem. And in some ways, it's surprising that the people used the palms at all. For the palms were a celebration that came after the battle was over. In victory, as someone returned, the palms were out. And yet we know from Jesus' perspective, the greatest battle was still ahead. As the people gathered, they'd wave the palms. And in some ways, it's not so surprising. They had seen with their eyes the miracles of Jesus, how he had healed a blind man, a leper, how he had driven out spirits, how he had even raised a little girl from the dead. And most recently, how he raised his friend Lazarus after he had been in the tomb for several days. Not surprisingly, they waved in anticipation and excitement. Royal gesture. But they also offered their cloaks. Jesus knew that the greatest battle was yet ahead. And so as he enters into the city, he heads directly for the temple and enters. As a warrior looking over the scene, to read the context, battlefield well. As he enters the temple, I wonder if he saw the same spot where he engaged with the teachers when he was 12 years old. If some smile didn't come to his face, remembering how vexed his parents were with him in that scene. And there he saw the altars of sacrifice, of burnt offering. The altars where animals were offered. I wonder, as he looked at that, what his thoughts were. As he knew that in a few days, all of that would change, there would be no more need for any animal sacrifice. For he, the Lamb of God, would make the ultimate and perfect, complete sacrifice. So none other would be made. As he looked and he took in where things were in the temple, I'm sure he also noticed the signs in Latin and Greek on the outer courts, forbidding Gentiles from entering in. Jesus took it all in, and then as it was late, he, the 12, went on to Bethany. Jesus promises that he will visit us. The story of Palm Sunday is a great story of Jesus' visitation. The people celebrated because he was coming home to them. And this morning, even though we're not gathered in a sanctuary of a building, Jesus still promises where two or more are gathered. Wherever you are this morning, Jesus promises to visit. And so I have a couple questions for you as you want to pause the tape again. As Jesus visits you this morning, what do you think he will notice in your home and in your heart? And also, what might you do to prepare for his coming this morning?